Maria once lived an ordinary life with her husband and two children. 1980s wasn't exactly a great time for the country's economy, so Maria went to Canada and worked to support her family, while her husband worked as a policeman. When she got to Canada, she worked as a caregiver to a very old man. Her employer was very kind to her despite the fact that they can hardly understand each other. One night, she found her employer on the verge of dying. He asked her to come closer, and when she did, he handed her a black stone and asked her to swallow it. Not knowing what it was, Maria did as she was told. When she finally swallowed the stone, her employer breathed his last and died. Out of work, Maria went back to the Philippines to her family. As the days passed, Maria felt ill and she felt hungry all the time, even though she just ate. Her husband noticed her strange behaviors like staying up all night, not going outside, and not talking to people. He thought she was just adjusting herself again to her provincial life. One night, Maria's husband came home from work and sat down for dinner. He asked, "Where's our children?" while eating a mouthful of Maria's home-cooked dish. Maria looked up at him and said, "They are over there," while she pointed at their stone. He later found out that Maria killed and cooked their kids, and he just ate a mouthful of it. He became enraged and slashed her face with a bolo or labo, as it's called in their province, that earned her the moniker Maria Labo. Because of this, she walks around with a big scar on her face. It was said that she escaped to the south, probably Visayas or Mindanao, still hungry for human flesh. It's also said that Maria travels around small towns and disguises herself as a beautiful woman to seduce and later eat young men, especially during festivals where parties are all around the area.